butter. I beg you.
You read flying magazines.
The butter. Trade journals on engineering. Aviation.
We read books.
Mm-hmm. Fat as Alexander Wolf.
Well, Howard has to read the trade pieces, Mom, because he's designing a new aeroplane.
Oh, really? Do tell.
Well, it's quite exciting, actually. It's a spy plane for the Air Corps. A twin-engine plane with some, I must admit, some rather unique design features. You see, it has these two booms.
Luddie built a birdhouse once. You remember that, dear?
Yes, well, a mere trifle, darling.
Oh, I remember the painting.
I hate the painting.
It's called May 18
hey,
or something.
Hey,
anyway, Goya is vastly overrated.
All the Spaniards are.
Nonsense. Picasso is sacred.
I'm a urologist.
It was quite aesthetic, really.
A sacred monster, that's what Picasso is.
The birds didn't care for it much, but the bats do.
I'll bet.
Oh, that's such...
Did you go to mechanic school to learn all this, you know, airplane guff?
No, I didn't, Luddie, no.
Well, Howard just flew around the world in 3 days,
don't you
know? I think
we've had enough about airplanes.
And dogs, apparently. Had a
well, then how'd you make all that money?
We don't care about money here, Mr. Hughes.
Well, that's because you have it.
Would you repeat that?
You don't care about money because you've always had it.
Well, then how did you make all that?
Excuse me, I'm speaking.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
Some of us choose to work for a living. Speaking of which, I have more of that airplane guff to attend to. Excuse me.
Well, seems a rather high-strung chap.
Where are the belts for this? Why is no one ready?
Here. It's a tough call. They're so different.
Something funny?
No, nothing's, you know, it's just that both those belts look exactly the same to me. You know, I'm still learning about this stuff and,
This stuff? Oh, okay, I see. You think this has nothing to do with you. You go to your closet and you select, I don't know, that lumpy blue sweater, for instance, because you're trying to tell the world that you take yourself too seriously to care about what you put on your back. But what you don't know is that that sweater is not just blue, it's not turquoise, it's not lapis, it's actually cerulean. And you're also blithely unaware of the fact that in 2002, Oscar de la Renta did a collection of cerulean gowns. And then I think it was Yves Saint Laurent, wasn't it, who showed cerulean military jackets? I think we need a jacket here. And then cerulean quickly showed up in the collections of 8 different designers. And then it filtered down through the department stores and then trickled on down into some tragic casual corner where you no doubt fished it out of some clearance bin. However, that blue represents millions of dollars and countless jobs. And it's sort of comical how you think that you've made a choice that exempts you from the fashion industry when in fact you're wearing a sweater that was selected for you by the people in this room from a pile of stuff.